and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. In this tutorial, we are going to look at drawing Lewis structures for molecules, and we are going to look at specific scenarios where we consider formal charge. So sometimes when you're drawing a Lewis structure, there are multiple Lewis structures that can be drawn that satisfy the octet rule. And so I want to look at carbon dioxide right here. If I'm drawing the Lewis structure for carbon dioxide, my Lewis structure is going to need to have 4 valence electrons from carbon and 6 valence electrons for each oxygen. Remember that you can determine the number of valence electrons for atoms of a given element from your periodic table based on the group number on the periodic table. And so our Lewis structure for carbon dioxide is going to have 16 valence electrons. So I would start drawing this Lewis structure with carbon in the middle, bonded to each of 2 oxygens. So I've used 2 and 4 electrons there, 2 electrons in each bond. And then I'll start filling in the octets of my atoms, leaving the central atom for last. So I'm going to put another 6 electrons here around oxygen and another 6 electrons here around oxygen. And you can see that in this structure, I've used all 16 valence electrons, but carbon doesn't have an octet of electrons. So we need to make some multiple bonds. So I'm going to start by moving a pair of electrons here from this oxygen into the middle. And you can see carbon is coming closer to having an octet of electrons, but we still need to give it 2 more electrons. And so I have a choice now. I could move a pair of electrons from this oxygen on the left, which would result in a Lewis structure overall looking like this, or I could move a pair of electrons from the oxygen on the right. And that would leave me with a Lewis structure that looked like this. Now, if you look at either of these Lewis structures, they both contain 16 electrons, and in both of them, all atoms are satisfying the octet rule. And so based on those 2 considerations, either of these Lewis structures would work. But what I want to do in this lecture is look at formal charge to consider which of these Lewis structures might be better. We'll call this Lewis structure 1. And here we'll call this structure 2. And so to consider formal charge, what we're going to do is we are going to look at our Lewis structure or structures and assign a formal charge to each of the atoms in our Lewis structure. And to assign this formal charge to each of our atoms, what we're going to look at is the number of valence electrons that atom has minus the number of electrons that are assigned to it in our Lewis structure. And the number of electrons that are assigned to it in the Lewis structure include all of the non-bonding electrons, so all of the lone pair electrons, and half of the bonded electrons. Okay, so here are the 2 Lewis structures we drew for carbon dioxide. And so what I want to do is I want to look at each of these Lewis structures with respect to considering the formal charge that is on each of the atoms in these Lewis structures. And so let's just start with this first oxygen right here, and let's consider the formal charge. So the formal charge is going to be equal to the number of valence electrons. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons, and I determine this because it's in group 6A on the periodic table. And then we are going to subtract from that all of the electrons that are assigned to this atom. So that includes all of the non-bonding electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and then half of the bonded electrons. So I'm going to do 1 electron from each bond. Remember, anytime you draw a bond in a Lewis structure, that represents 2 electrons. So 1 electron from each bond, or half of the bonded electrons. The total number of bonded electrons here would be 4, so half of those bonded electrons, or 1 from each bond, would be 2. And so 6 minus 4 minus 2, the formal charge of oxygen in this structure is 0. And we're going to do this for each of the atoms in our structure. So let's move on to carbon here. If I were to calculate the formal charge of carbon, carbon has 4 valence electrons, and let's subtract from that all of the electrons assigned to it. So all non-bonding electrons, which there aren't any in carbon here, and half of the bonded electrons, or one from each bond. So carbon in this structure has 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons assigned to it, one from each bond, or half of the total bonding electrons, which would be half of 8. And so the formal charge for carbon in this structure, 4 minus 4, is 0. Okay, what about this last oxygen? Formal charge is going to be equal to the number of valence electrons, so 6, minus any non-bonding electrons, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1 electron from each bond. So there are 2. And so 6 minus 4 minus 2, again, is 0. So in this structure here that we drew, the structure on the left, every atom in this structure has a formal charge of 0. Now let's consider the structure that I drew on the right. Again, the structure on the right satisfies the octet rule and contains the correct number of valence electrons. So let's start with this oxygen here. And the formal charge is going to be equal to the number of valence electrons. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons, so you determine this again from your periodic table. And then we'll subtract the number of electrons assigned to it, all of the non-bonding electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and half of the bonded electrons, or 1 electron from each bond. So 1 electron from this bond. And so 6 minus 6 minus 1 gives the oxygen in this structure a formal charge of negative 1. Okay, let's look at carbon. So the formal charge of carbon is going to be equal to the number of valence electrons. Carbon has 4 valence electrons, minus the number of electrons assigned to it. So 1 from each bond, 1, 2, 3, 4. And so 4 minus 4 in this structure, carbon has a formal charge of 0. And one less oxygen here. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons. Let's subtract from this the number of electrons assigned to it, which again include all of the non-bonding electrons, so 2, and then half of the electrons, or 1 electron from each bond, so there's 3. So 6 minus 2 minus 3, this oxygen has a formal charge of plus 1. And so when you look at the formal charge of atoms in a Lewis structure, the sum of the formal charges on all of the atoms in the molecule should equal the overall charge on the molecule. And you can see that's true for the structure here and also for the structure I drew on the right. But generally, the most correct Lewis structure should minimize the formal charges on individual atoms. And so you can see here that the structure on the left, every atom in the structure has a formal charge of 0, where over here in the structure on the right, one of the oxygens has a formal charge of negative 1, and one of the oxygens has a formal charge of plus 1. And so we would pick this as the better structure for carbon dioxide, because all of these atoms have a formal charge of 0. Now, the second caveat here we will consider in the next example. Okay, so let's look at these two structures for the phosphate ion. And I didn't go through drawing the Lewis structure with you. If you need more help drawing Lewis structures, I do have a tutorial for that. I just am showing you here two Lewis structures. These are both correct Lewis structures for the phosphate ion. But I want to consider the formal charge on each of the atoms in each of these structures. And so let's start with our structure on the left. And I'm going to look at this oxygen here. So the formal charge is going to be equal to the number of valence electrons. Again, that you determine from the periodic table. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons. Minus the number of electrons that are assigned to it. And so the number of electrons that are assigned to it include all of the non-bonding electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And half of the bonding electrons, And so half of the bonding electrons is always one electron from each bond. So that's why I'm just coloring half of the bond here. And so the formal charge on this oxygen is going to be -1. And now if you look at the remaining oxygen atoms in this structure, notice they all have 6 non-bonding electrons and are forming one bond, same as the oxygen down here on the bottom. And so these oxygens will also all have a formal charge of -1. Okay, let's look at the phosphorus atom now though. So phosphorus has 5 valence electrons. And let's subtract the number of electrons that are assigned to it in this structure. And so there are no lone pairs of electrons around phosphorus. So we count 1 electron from each bond, half of the bonding electrons. There are 4 total. And so you can see the formal charge on phosphorus here is +1. Now, if we look at this overall structure and you look at the formal charges on all of the atoms in this structure, you have -1, -1, -1, -1, and +1. Overall, the sum of those equals the overall charge on the ion, which is -3. Okay, so let's compare that now to the structure on the right. Okay, so if I look at this oxygen down here on the bottom, you can see that this oxygen down here on the bottom has 6 non-bonding electrons and is making one bond to phosphorus. So just like the oxygens in our last structure, the oxygen on the bottom and the oxygen on the left and the oxygen on the top are all going to have a formal charge of -1. Notice this oxygen on the right looks a little bit different. So let's calculate the formal charge for this oxygen. Formal charge is going to be equal to the number of valence electrons minus the number of non-bonding electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, minus half the bonding electrons or 1 electron from each bond. So 1, 2. And so 6 - 4 - 2 in this structure, this oxygen has a formal charge of 0. Now let's consider the formal charge for phosphorus in this structure. So phosphorus has 5 valence electrons. There are no non-bonding electrons, but phosphorus is making 5 bonds, so the number of electrons assigned to it in this structure, 1 from each bond, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so the formal charge on the phosphorus in this structure is 0. And so notice how when we went from the structure on the left to this structure on the right, that less atoms have a formal charge that isn't 0. So we have 3 oxygen atoms that each have a formal charge of -1. And that's going to have to be the case because the sum of the formal charges on all of the atoms in our Lewis structure has to equal the overall charge on the molecule. But in forming this double bond here between the phosphorus and the oxygen, I was able to create a structure where now one of the oxygens had a formal charge of 0 and phosphorus also had a formal charge of 0. Now remember that we can do this over here on the right because phosphorus can violate the octet rule with more than 8 electrons. And so I would say with respect to formal charge considerations, this structure is the better one over here on the right. Okay, let's do one more example together. And so what I'm showing you here are some different Lewis structures for the cyanate ion. And again, all of these are correct Lewis structures. These all contain 16 valence electrons, and every atom in these structures have an octet. So we've drawn a Lewis structure that satisfies our 2 most general Lewis structure rules. But now what I want to look at is if you can draw this Lewis structure in multiple ways, which one would be the best considering formal charge? So what we're going to do is we're going to go through and assign, again, formal charges to all of the atoms in all of our Lewis structures. So I'm going to start at the top and I'm going to start with oxygen. So oxygen here has 6 valence electrons. How many electrons did I assign to it? I've assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons here. And so this oxygen has a formal charge of +1. Okay, what about carbon? Carbon has 4 valence electrons, and in this structure, I have assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons, one from each bond. So carbon has a formal charge of 0. And nitrogen here, nitrogen has 5 valence electrons. And in this structure, I have assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 electrons. And so nitrogen has a formal charge in this structure of -2. Okay, let's go through our remaining structures. And so in the second structure, oxygen, again, has 6 valence electrons. And in this structure, I've assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So oxygen has a formal charge of -1. For carbon, carbon has 4 valence electrons, and I have assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons. So carbon has a formal charge of 0. And nitrogen has 5 valence electrons, and in this structure, I have assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons. So nitrogen also has a formal charge of 0. Okay, last structure. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons, and in this structure, I have assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrons. So oxygen has a formal charge of 0 in this structure. Carbon has 4 valence electrons, and in this structure, I've assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons. So carbon has a formal charge of 0. And nitrogen has 5 valence electrons, and in this structure, I have assigned to it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrons. So nitrogen has a formal charge of -1. Okay, so remember when we're considering formal charge, we want to minimize the magnitude of the formal charges on any individual atoms and minimize the number of individual atoms that have a formal charge. So that means that this first structure up here, where oxygen has a formal charge and nitrogen has a formal charge, is not going to be as good as either 2 or 3, where only one of those atoms has a formal charge. So now considering structures 2 and 3, which one would be better? So notice in both of these structures that only one atom has a formal charge. In structure 2, it's oxygen that has the formal charge of -1. And in structure 3, it's nitrogen that has the formal charge of -1. Well, if you have to have formal charges on individual atoms in your structure, you want to have any negative formal charges on the more electronegative atom or atoms, if that's required. And so in this scenario, oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen, so we would want the formal charge of -1 to be on the oxygen atom. And so this would be our best Lewis structure for the cyanate ion based on formal charge considerations. Okay, that wraps up this tutorial. I hope that was helpful.